In the ghetto, we were lucky because I was in the district that where was the actual, it's called horror house in Budapest, in Andrássy Boulevard, where it was the headquarters of the Nazis. And it was 2 minutes walk from where I was in the Yellow Star house. So we were between the first house, practically, or a second, who was taken in the ghetto, and we were able to find a room and a bed for my, shared with my mother. So we were lucky because we had a bed where we could sleep. Because later on it was, people live, a lot of people, we were, six people lived in this room, but every day people who was bombed out because the ghetto not escape from the bombing because they couldn't. So a lot of people was bombed on the night, so the poor people, they have to find a place where they could go in to spend the night. And one day I remember my friend came with her mom and they spent the night, she said, but they couldn't stay. So sometimes it was 12 people for the night, they were sitting on the floor. So it was not a very good place. And then the food is supposed to be a central kitchen, and they're supposed to give us some soup and a little bread, but not every day. So we didn't have anything to eat. I really don't know how we survived. I don't know. I know my mother was terribly run down at all. And then I just wanted to stay in bed. But I was worried about the bombing. I wanted to go around to the shelter. And we didn't want to separate from each other. So she just come down, and there also, if you are lucky, you got a seat, but not you have to sit in the floor. There was no chairs, nothing. And it was, other thing was very hard, where I remember the cold, because there was no heating. And that that winter, it was before January, because January we were liberated already, it was minus 17, and it was no heating, and was no hot water, was nothing. So I really don't know how we survived. Of course, I was too young to take it in, you know, I just couldn't take it in, really, what's happening. You know, young people just, you know, you're full up with, supposed to be full up with life, you know. So I just couldn't understand. I just went with it, you know. I did the best. So it was very hard. And one day when they brought the food, a bomb came. A small bomb, and then the people were killed. The big, they were carrying the soup, and they were all dead. And the soup was on the road. And then we were supposed to go when our turn was to carry the food, you know. But my mother said, "We're not going." And if we don't get the food, but we got some time. What they got. And by that time, the bombing was very heavy. And rumors came in the ghetto, rumors. But we didn't believe. They said that they were taking people and killed them, but we didn't know exactly the details. And I remember my poor mother, it was before we went to the ghetto, she always cried. And it turned out that was the time when her mother and her brothers and the whole family was taken to Auschwitz, you know. Only one brother came back. My mother had three brothers. One brother came back, and from my father, only two. They were about six. They didn't come back. You know that it's somehow people think that we were privileged in Budapest, in Hungary, but because they didn't have the transport, they couldn't take us away anymore. They were desperate. It was the last stage of the war, actually, and then they just actually, the Germans absolutely didn't care. It was the Nazis who was friendly with the Nazis, and they were worse than the Nazis, the Germans. I have to tell you, they were worse, the Hungarians. And then they just was carrying on with their dirty works, you know. And then they just couldn't get the transport, so they was not taken away. And also they said that the Russians is very nearby, because some people came to the ghetto. Actually, I just talked to Antea today. She's going to Targu Mureș tomorrow. And I said I met a boy from this area who was in the concentration camp, and he survived. And then he was moving with the army who was liberated the countries, you know. They were coming to Budapest. And then he was advised, he said, to go to the ghetto, because this is the most severe place for a person who have nowhere to go. So a few people came, and they said stories, but they didn't know much either, you know, or they didn't want to tell, I think, rather. So they didn't say that about Auschwitz. They didn't say names at all, you know. But it was a lot of rumors. And then what is actually affected us was they said that they put mine down to the ghetto, mines. Mm-hmm. And the Germans going to blow up the ghetto before they goes away. That is what they said. And then during the ghetto, it was not very peaceful, just shortly, because every day they came with something new, looking for people, shooting people, take out people. So we had to exercise how to escape. And the example, they came to one house, in the cellar, they took out the bricks, and we had to exercise to crawl over to the next house, because it was a big area for 100,000 people. It was a very big area. There is a picture in the ghetto. And so we just heard that I don't know how many rode down in the ghetto. Six people were shot. And one day, they actually wanted to take me. Somebody reported me. But luckily, God helped me, and they didn't take me away. We were liberated on the 18th of January, Budapest, very early that day. And the 17th, just to finish, was extremely heavy bombing. And then people who know a little bit what's going on, they said this is a night when it's decided that we're going to die or we're going to live. So everybody just was sitting in the shelter, and then nobody said a word. Everybody was praying and crying, but we couldn't do anything. We couldn't run away. We couldn't do anything. So very early morning, suddenly about 2 o'clock, quiet, became very quiet. And we didn't know why, what's happening. And then nobody were allowed to go up to see you know, from the shelter. But a bit later, one man went up and he said that he saw two Russian soldiers on the road. But still, they said that just stay calm, don't go anywhere. And then we just had to wait. And maybe after an hour, some high-rank Russian person came and they told us that you are liberated, you are a free person, and you can go wherever you want.